Hello, my name is Vafa Peleva, and today I'm going to talk about storage-based virtual machine snapshots on KVM. But let me say something more about myself. I work in StorePool Storage as a Java developer. My hobbies are winter sports and rollerblades. And I hope you know that most of the developers don't like to talk much in front of people, so I'm not an exception. And this is my first presentation, so please show, give me all your support. And if I make any mistakes or miss something, I apologize for this. I hope you enjoy it. My presentation today is about storage-based virtual machine snapshots on KVM. This is a new functionality which is using the data storage provider's capability for disk snapshots, but the end result will be virtual machine snapshot. There will be a question. We have already functionality about virtual machine snapshots and why we need this. And the answer is simple. But I have to include a bit of history here. CloudStack and KVM as a hypervisor supports two types of snapshots: virtual machine snapshots and disk snapshots, also known as volume snapshots. The virtual machine snapshots are snapshots of the whole virtual machine, the virtual machine state, memory, and all disks attached to the virtual machine. And the other types, also, I forget, it works only vir, and the old disk attached to the virtual machine has to be in QCAL format. The other type, disk snapshots, are snapshots of a single disk of the virtual machine. It could be taken in any state of the virtual machine, running or stop. Here I have to include more information. CloudStack provides the opportunity for storage for third-party storage providers to integrate with it. Those plugins could provide their own functionality for create, revert, and delete snapshots. And there is also a default implementation in CloudStack which uses libvirt camel KVM to do the snapshotting. And default snapshots, they work on libvirt camel KVM, and also NFS is using the default implementation. Here, what happens if we have virtual machine with raw disks on it? We'll get this error because libvirt supports only images in QCAL format. So if we want a consistent snapshot of the virtual machine with disks that are in raw format, we have to stop the virtual machine and to snapshot all disks separately, one by one. But it's not recommended for a public server if you are stopping the virtual machine. Do you know what means consistent? Okay. I was preparing an example for this, but I'll skip it. I'm going to talk about disk snapshot, but the end result will be virtual machine snapshot. To create such a snapshot, we are employing the underlying storage provider's capability to create snapshots. The workaround is to create consistent snapshot while the virtual machine is running, and in the end you have virtual machine snapshot but without its state and memory. Let's look at the picture here. We have two virtual machines. The first one has two StorePool disks, and to create a virtual machine snapshot here, we are using our integration with CloudStack to do the snapshotting of the volumes disks. And here is the, we will use again the data storage provider's implementation for Ceph and NFS to create consistent snapshot of the virtual machine too. This was the high-level design of our solution, and if you want to use this implementation, you can set in the global settings, the option KVM VM snapshot enable to true. And if you want to make a consistent snapshot, with this, we are freezing the virtual machine, and while it's frozen, we snapshot all this separately, as it is asynchronous. And after successful snapshot, we unfreeze the virtual machine. Here is shown a virtual machine snapshot without a memory, and here there are two disk volume snapshots. The UUID of the virtual machine uses, we are using it as a prefix of the volume snapshot name, and this state, backup for VM, shows us that this is related to the virtual machine snapshot and could not be deleted or reverted separately. After a successful snapshot of the volume, we do the backup. The backup is when we move the snapshot from primary storage to secondary storage. And like everything in the world, now our solution even has some imperfections. They are related to default data store implementation. And I'll show you one example. If we have one virtual machine with two disks, one is safe and the second one is NFS, if we need to snapshot the NFS disk, we will get an exception, this one, because libvirt will check all the disks attached to the virtual machine, and it will catch that there is a row image safe. And to avoid getting errors in cases like this, we have a new feature for the default implementation, which uses CAMU command drive backup. Its functionality is start a point in time copy of a block device to another destination. But this functionality is slow because it makes a full copy of the disk. And also we have another limitation. We don't save the virtual machine state and memory. So you need an example when it's needed, the virtual machine state or memory?
While running, for sure.
I'm sorry?
While the VM is running, you need to, if you avoid the VM snapshot, you need to snap the memory.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, it's pretty much possible that you will not have consistent state to restore.
By the way, do you use anywhere the state of the virtual machine, and do you recover to the running state, a virtual machine in the running state? Do you have such a case in practice?
I don't remember, to be honest, if I ever reverted to a snapshot, previous snapshot state where the VM is running.
Yes, with KVM and Kevzan, I did that.
No, it can be done. Absolutely,
no, we want that for a second.
Yes.
The question is, do you have a real use case that you need
yes.
to do this? Okay.
Well, the use case is if the VM doesn't allow to be stopped for before taking VM snapshots. You can't afford downtime, let's say.
No, I mean, if you revert to a existing state, then you'll get your virtual machine back in time.
Yes,
so,
memory and disks, everything, yeah.
Yeah, this is okay if the virtual machine works on its own, but for the rest of the environment, they'll go ahead of time, and you'll get your data will not be synchronized between the data in the virtual machine and the other.
Environment. From the network point of view, that's understandable.
Yeah.
Just a comment on the previous slide. You might want to explore using this Rados Java, the previous one. Sorry, even the previous one. So itself, Liver doesn't support taking VM volume snapshots. So Vido, for that reason, specifically wrote Rados Java, which is by default available in Cloud Stack, and you consume that library. Let's put it that way to produce snapshots on self, revert, delete, stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
So that's something you might want if you have.
I mean, this is for NFS, and you have two disks. One is raw, and the other one is in QCAV.
Yeah, QCAV is only available, possible for VMs.
No, the problem is
yes, but
two type of
if you have yes,
yeah, if they are not all. If they're not all QCAL2, then yes, you cannot capture.
Yeah, that's exactly the case.
Yeah. That's,
KVM, yeah.
That's KVM's limitations. The relative itself is quasi, I don't know, whatever, solid fire, although there it's actually implemented as a storage snapshot as well. But yeah.
So our solution works for sure with NFS, Ceph, and StorePool. We have tested it with those three storage providers. We have made a lot of test scenarios with them. And for reverse Ceph disk, I want to note that there's a bug related with reverted Ceph disk, but Gabriel Brasher raised a ticket and solution in CloudStack for this fixed, but it's not merged yet. If you want to use this solution, you need to install the following software. CAM guest agent is needed to freeze and tout the virtual machine. Also, the drive backup appears in CAM 1.6 version. And if you're using the latest stable Ubuntu, it will be included. But for CentOS 7, you should need to install CAM KVM EV package, which is proposed by Red Hat Enterprise Virtualization and is backed by CentOS. Also, we have our separate solution for virtual machine snapshot. This is for disks only for customers that are using StorePool only, and this virtual machine disk should be only on StorePool. It works, it creates a crash consistent snapshot it creates crash consistent group snapshot of the virtual machine, and you don't need any additional software to freeze the virtual machine. And that was everything from me. I was fast.
Thank you.